Below are the problems done on this video. This is part four of complex numbers. So far we defined the imaginary unit, we simplified, we multiplied, we added and we subtracted. And so we're going to start off by doing some problems where we're going to be multiplying complex numbers. So I want you to try these two problems on your own. Keep in mind it's similar to what you do when you're working with binomials, but you've got to remember that I squared equals negative 1 when that comes up. So put the video on pause and try these two problems. So when you're squaring this, it's usually easier for people to write it out as 2 plus 3i times 2 plus 3i, and then do the FOIL method. Although if you know the formula for squaring a binomial, that works just as well. So if we do the FOIL method, we have 2 times 2, which is 4. The outer term, 2 times 3i will be 6i. As well as the inner term. That's what happens when you multiply, when you square a binomial, your two middle terms will be the same. But then what happens here for the last term, 3i times 3i, we get 9i squared. Okay, now the two in the middle are the two quote like terms, but they're really just an imaginary number. They're really not variables. And let's concentrate on this 9i squared. What does that mean? Well, that means 9 times negative 1. So 9i squared is simply going to be negative 9. So I have 4 plus 12i, adding the two middle terms, and then I have minus 9. So if we add the real parts, 4 minus 9, you get negative 5 plus 12i, and we're writing it in standard form, a plus bi with the real part first and then the imaginary part. So that's what hopefully you got when you did 2 plus 3i, the whole thing squared. Be careful that you don't just write 4 plus 9i squared or something like that. You're going to have this middle term of the 12i when you multiply it out. So be careful with that. All right, let's look at this next one. 4 plus 3i times 4 minus 3i. Let's do the same thing. We've got 4 times 4 is 16. The outer term will be minus 12i, and the inner term will be plus 12i, and the last term will be minus 9i squared. Same reasoning as before, that minus 9i squared becomes a negative 9 times a negative 1, since I squared is negative 1. So when I simplify this further, let's see, what happens to the middle terms here? I have a negative 12i and a plus 12i. So those add up to 0. And this minus 9i squared becomes, well, what's negative 9 times negative 1? Plus 9. So check it out. I end up with a real number. I multiplied these two complex numbers and I got a real number. Let's see. Here's another one for you to try. How about 6 minus 5i times 6 plus 5i? This is similar. Let's see if you can see the pattern. Go ahead and put the video on pause and try that one. Okay, what do we get here? We have 6 times 6 is 36. The outer term is plus 30i. In the inner term is minus 30i. Okay, it's going to happen again. Those two terms, there's two imaginary numbers, are going to add up to 0. And then the last term is minus 25i squared. All right, these two middle terms, they're going to cancel out. And what's going to happen with this minus 25i squared? Basically, that I squared is negative 1, so it's always going to just change the sign. Right? Just like up here. Notice it had a minus 9i squared, ended up being a plus 9. The same exact thing will happen here because negative 25 times negative 1 is plus 25. So I end up with 36 plus 25 and I got a real number again. Let's see. Do you notice anything interesting about these two problems? They're kind of in the form a plus b times a minus b. So you have a squared minus b squared. But there's a little bit of a difference here. It really had an I in there. And notice what happened in the end because of that I. You ended up adding two perfect squares. Kind of interesting, huh? So let's look at it. Let's observe these two problems. 4 plus 3i times 4 minus 3i. What happened? I end up getting 16 plus 9. I'm adding two real numbers and I get a real number. It's not a complex number. When I multiplied these two complex numbers, I ended up with a real number. Same thing for 6 minus 5i times 6 minus, I'm sorry, times 6 plus 5i. Well, that's because this is a special form here. Both of these complex numbers have a certain form. We have a plus bi and a minus bi. So one of the numbers looks like a plus bi, the other one looks like a minus bi, and these are called complex conjugates. Okay, so that's the term. All right, what happens when you multiply complex conjugates? Well, if we have a plus bi times a minus bi, this is similar to x plus y times x minus y, which gives you a difference of two squares. So let's do it that way. We have a times a, the first term squared is a squared, minus, and then we do b squared. But in this case, what's our second term? It's bi. So I have to do bi times bi. That's b squared I squared. Then since I squared is negative 1, we end up with a squared plus b squared. So when all said and done, when you multiply complex conjugates, you get a squared plus b squared. What does that mean? A is the real part and b is the imaginary part, the coefficient of I. So if we look back to our original problem up here, the a in 4 plus 3i and 4 minus 3i was 4, so we got 4 squared, plus the b was 3, the coefficient of I. Notice it's not plus the 3i squared. I'm saying it's plus just the b squared, plus 9. And so now we're going to work some more problems, and we have to be able to recognize and figure out what the conjugate is. How about if we had 3 plus 5i? What would the conjugate of 3 plus 5i be? Well, it looks exactly the same, except there will be a minus sign. 3 minus 5i. So first of all, hopefully you know how to get the conjugate. Next, we can go through and do everything we did the long way. You could do the FOIL method. 9 minus 15i plus 15i minus 25i squared. And that ends up being 9 plus 25 because the middle terms cancel and this becomes a plus 25 when I do negative 25 times negative 1 and I get 34. Okay? Or here's the shortcut. It ends up being, that's your a and that's your b, right? It ends up being the squares of those two numbers added together. So 3 squared plus 5 squared. It ends up being just 9 plus 25, or 34. Here are two problems for you to try. They are not the same. One is 7 plus I times 7 minus I. Those are conjugates being multiplied together. And this is your squaring a complex number, 7 plus I. Let's put the video on pause and try each of these problems. All right, we can do our shortcut here if you'd like, or you can multiply out using the FOIL method. Let's do the shortcut. Now, remember, you have to know what a and b are. What is the value of a? Well, that's the easy part. That's 7. But what's the value of b? What number do you see here? You don't see anything in front of that I. What would that be then? That would be a 1. All right. So the shortcut is just 7 squared plus 1 squared. 49 plus 1 is 50. Be careful. Don't do 49 plus I squared. Nope, it's plus 1 squared. Now, you could also do this the long way, and you would end up with 7 squared minus I squared, which is 49 minus negative 1, and that's another way to get the answer of 50. All right, and this one, you're squaring a binomial, so you have to multiply it out. Let's see, we get 49 plus 7i plus 7i plus I squared. And what's going to happen here? This I squared is negative 1. We'll have a 49 minus 1. Remember, if we combine those two, we get 48. And 7i plus 7i is 14i. Now, in the next video, we'll see why we need to know what conjugates are and how they're going to be useful for dividing with complex numbers.